we have a triangle problem. You want to find the length of side AB. So, if you want to try this out right now, before I solve it, try it. I'm going to solve it now. So, in our handbook, we get given this sample triangle, and we get a few equations that you know, that correspond to this triangle. So one of the equations is called the law of sines. And it says that the length of some side, of any of these sides, over its opposite angle will be equal to any other of the same kind of thing. So B over sine B equals C over sine C. So the opposite angle of the side over its opposite angle is equal to any other side over its opposite angle, if that makes sense. And this isn't a sinc function, that's a sine of C. I just didn't write that earlier. So we can use that to solve this problem here. So I'll start solving it actually in blue. So this is what's given in the equation sheet. This is our problem. Now I'm solving it. So we know the angle A, we know the angle B. Let's just write down everything we know. It's 45 degrees. B is 110 degrees. C, well, we don't know what the degrees of this, but we can find that pretty easily because all triangles angles sum to 180. I don't know if this is in the book, but just know that triangles they always total at 180. So if we take 180 minus 110 minus 45 degrees, I believe that's 25 degrees. Yep. So now we know the angle of C. This is a 25 degrees here. We know what B is. We want to know what length AB is. So that's this length here, right? So what does that correspond to on this triangle? C. Good job. C is what we want. That's the question mark. So now we have enough, if you start looking, we have enough information because we have B. Okay, B's right there. We have big B, which is right there. And we have big C. We want to know C. So we only have one variable left, one equation, perfect. So here we go. B equals C over sine B over sine C. So C is equal to little b sine C over sine of B. And we plug in everything. B is 10 centimeters, sine of 25 degrees, sine of 110 degrees. Let me make sure big B is 110. Yep, it is. So C would be equal to 4.49 centimeters, which is roughly equal to like 4.5. So a big thing with the FE is you will always get kind of like answers that aren't exactly on the multiple choice, and then you have to either round up or down to the most near. So most problems are like find most nearly length of side AB. Because, they want you to be able to round and, like, not be able to just guess the answers, essentially. So you're going to get some You're gonna have to do it rounding and make sure you don't fuck that up. That's what I'm trying to get at here. But yeah, hopefully that problem isn't too hard. I mean, there's a few other equations that come with this thing, but you just gotta kind of feel out which one's the easiest, and this is like definitely the easiest way to solve this. So, yep. Like, subscribe, whatever. Peace.